In a laboratory setting, you can artificially control different parts of the problem, so each effect can be isolated. That's hard to find in nature.
Seoul, South Korea. A megacity with over 25 million people and a population density which is almost twice that of New York and 8 times greater than Rome. Despite being a modern and massive megacity, South Korea still counts with many forests and rural farming communities throughout the country. But why is South Korea an ideal natural laboratory to carry out air quality studies?
We have a bunch of factors. We have a very large city, a megacity, the fourth largest city on the planet, with lots of cars, lots of power plants. And then downwind from that, we have a forest. So we have the urban plume reacting with the natural emissions from the forest.
This is a perfect place on the globe to try to understand how the mixture between man's emissions and nature's emissions can create poor air quality.
Air pollution is an important environmental problem in modern societies. The rapid growth of new economies and industries in developing countries makes it very difficult to address environmental issues.
Korea has been developed very quickly after the Korean War. Actually, economic success gave us lots of benefits to the people. However, this also brought many environmental issues, including air quality.
So general public has been known about the yellow dust issue before, and in recent they start to learn about the fine particle issues and ozone issues. They're starting to pay their attention to those newer issues emerging to our society.
Korean government has been making persistent effort to improve air quality. We participate in this project as though understanding of current situation with aerial, ground, ship, on the top of current simple ground observation, crucial in future improving air quality.
We are definitely pay attention to solve this issue, and general public wants to know how we can actually achieve that goal.
Developing effective strategies to balance the economic growth and the good health of the population is key to continue growing and prospering as a society.
Unfortunately, policy always lags emissions, and so it usually takes time to understand what's causing the poor air quality, and then regulations can take effect.
It's a tough problem. We haven't solved it completely in the U.S., but here I think you're right. We're learning a lot more about the specific sources in this area so that here locally the government can decide what's the most effective strategies to use, because we don't want to hinder economic development. We just want to know what are the smartest choices you can make so you get the best bang for the buck.
In the United States and in Europe, this has taken place over a long period of time. Things in Asia are growing very rapidly, and so we're in the middle of that process.
But the difference is that now, with our knowledge and technology, we are better prepared to address these complex environmental issues.
In these days, many countries in East Asia have been developing very quickly as well. KORUS-AQ mission makes people aware of the seriousness of current air pollution.
So we are thinking, based on this mission, more general understanding, getting better and better, and eventually we can find something to actually reflect to the strategy.
KORUS-AQ mission results will help develop improved ways to assess this challenging task.
Current investigation will definitely help us gain deep understanding of air pollution phenomenon in global scale.